Hey everybody, how are you guys doing today? Bernard got into the barn. If you guys have watched any of our previous channels, you do know that Bernard has a tendency to stalk us, no matter what we're doing. So, case in point, you're probably going to hear him. We can't chase him anymore. He free ranges. He just comes back. He's the boss. I've come to accept that. I just don't know how I feel about it. But anyway, the whole point of this video today is we are stepping up our grow game this year. Now, Rob's on the other side of the camera.
Hey.
He's helping me shoot the video. And he has all the stats and everything I'm going to bring up in his head. I don't have anything. But we have decided, you guys, to take it to the max, to take it to the next level. Well, okay, of course, our level. So last year, we did fantastic. We had garden beds. Everything was great. We had great produce. We had abundance in some things. Okra grew till it was like October, November. It was crazy. It was just a mass producer. But we've decided to streamline it and take it to like a whole new level. I think we started our starts a little late last year, but we did have a late frost also. So that kind of really hurt us. So even if I had put them out, I probably would have lost everything. I did lose some things from putting things out a little bit too early. So this year, we're going to upgrade. So if you've watched our videos before, you know that we raise our own meat chickens. We process our own meat chickens. We have ducks. We have turkeys. Case in point, Papa Bear back there, who you keep hearing, Bernard. And we also now have introduced Cooney Coonies. So we will have our own pork. So now that I feel like we are actually getting to that point of sustainability with growing our own meat, we're comfortable with that. Growing vegetables is fine and great, and it's not that it's difficult. I just feel like we can streamline it and get it a little bit more efficient for us. It's not that we weren't paying it as much attention, with all the animals and all of that and learning how to get all that, and we may have neglected it just a little bit and not had it as streamlined as we possibly can. So this year we're like, okay, we've got the animal part down. Now we're going to rock our garden. So chickens, oh y'all, let me tell you about some chickens. So with the chickens, we did clip their wings and we had, you know, fencing up, but it just wasn't good enough fencing. It was just something really cheap and really fast. It was probably maybe 3 feet high. Yeah. Sorry, y'all have the hiccups. And it didn't do the job necessary. We could have put more work into it. But like I said, we were busy with the animals. It didn't have the time. So this year, we're going to step that game up. Since we're going to, as you can see behind me, to make the effort and really make sure that we produce really well, we need to protect our crop that we're going to grow. So the first thing is protection. So we are actually have been purchasing these like one or two a week because they're kind of expensive. I think they're $30, right around $30.
$28.
So they're kind of pricey, and we are going to need a lot of them because we do have quite a few beds that we grow on. This type of material, they're not giving this to us. We get it at Tractor Supply. No, we buy this. I can't remember what it's called. You can tell it's never happened to me before. So we've been buying these like one or two a week just to kind of keep it so we can budget it, because we do know in May when we start putting everything into the ground, we want to have them protected. So we have a few months to get the materials that we need, so it's not all out of our pocket at one time, because then it would not be an option because it'd be too expensive because of the amount that we need. So we've been getting a couple of these, one or two, you know, every pay period, and just storing them away. And that way, when it comes time, we'll have the materials necessary. So this is what we're going to do for the fence. So all the fencing that we have, which was just, what do you call that wire that we used out there?
It was a bird netting. It was just a more fine bird netting. It was real soft and wasn't quite as rigid as this netting is we're going to be using.
Yeah, this is like awesome netting. You guys, I don't know if you've ever seen it, but I'm sure you have. It's at Tractor Supply. It seems like it's some pretty tough stuff. So I'm hoping that this does the job. We're going to give it a try. We've got the T-post and everything already. We're going to do massive wing clippings. So let's see. So this is what we're going to do to protect the gardens. Now what we're going to do to start the gardens is this right back here. So this is what we have decided to do. Now there's a little story behind this, and if y'all know me on a personal level, you know I can't show something without telling some sort of story. So this thing right here, this rack. So Rob calls me. Rob, as you guys know, is my husband. If you've watched our previous channels or follow us on Instagram, he's behind the camera. So he calls me and he's like, hey babe, I am able to get this metal rack from work. They're closing down this section of the warehouse and they're just getting rid of it. And I'm like, how big is it? Like, would it be worth it? What is the dimensions of this, darling? Guessy?
Probably 10 foot long by 2 feet wide.
And he tells me that. So I'm like, oh yeah, that'll be great. In the bar, we can get it all set up. And because he's made racks before, and he's made our drawing racks.
I think it's 12 by 2. 12 by 2 by 5 tall, maybe.
Well, I'm 5'7".
All right, almost 6 then.
Like, I'm 5'7" already, so, you know. So, was that weird? This is how tall I am, you guys measure me. So, he has built our dry racks. For our vegetables and stuff. So he's done our drying racks before. And so we actually have discussed he was just going to build something back here, which would have been fine. So I'm like, yeah, sure, bring it home. Are you going to be able to get it? He's like, it's pretty big. And I'm like, oh, it can't. In my brain, y'all, I don't know measurements at all. He pulls up in the truck with this, and I thought I was just going to fall out. It just about killed us, y'all, getting this in here. When I tell you it's
made of thick gauge aluminum.
It's not even, Rob and I carried this from our driveway all the way up the yard, all the way back through the chicken coop and into the barn. I told him it will live here forever. If we ever move or we ever get different property, I will never pick this up again. It is so heavy, but it was free, and y'all, it's awesome. It is so, so awesome. So this is where we're going to grow this year. Here's what we've got set up. This is how we're going to get our vegetables, and everything started this year. So we've got our lights, and then we have our heat mats. There's heat mats under each area, and then of course the trays go on top of the heat mats, and they'll have the covered plastic little dome to get them to go ahead and germinate. We have different styles and sizes of trays, depending on what we're putting in each tray.
We got 72s and 128s.
Yeah, 128 and 72. We actually even have some that we have left open spaces because we do grow in some different, a little bit larger than this too. I just haven't put them in yet. So this is going to be how we do our starts for this year on both levels. I'm super excited about how it has turned out. I think this is going to be such a fantastic device to have. The lights, of course, can raise up and down, so as they get larger, of course. I do like the fact that they have so much room in between each rack, because, you know, sometimes it just depends. Some things can shoot up super quick, and other things not so much. We're going to get our pepper started ASAP, because peppers take so long to germinate. I probably should have already done those last weekend, but it's all right, not a big deal. So this is what we've got going on so far. I wanted to take a minute and just show you guys what we're trying to do this year, how we're trying to like up our game, get the best and efficient way to get our vegetables and fruit grown for this year. I just wanted to take you along for the journey. If you guys have any questions or comments or maybe ideas, if there's something that we could do that you don't see that we're doing that we need to do, please shoot us a comment below and let us know. And once again, thank you so much for stopping by the channel and having an interest in what we're doing. Talk to y'all later. Till next time. Bye.
Bye.